Hey everybody, Sarah here. With the homeschool year starting soon, or maybe you already started, I just thought it would be fun to give you guys a little bit of a tour of our homeschool, what it kind of looks like and what we do. So I thought today I could share with you our morning routine, and I can give you a little tour of our actual physical homeschool space. And then maybe starting tomorrow, I thought I could share with you our curriculum. I'd really like to tell you, you know, what I love about it and why we chose what we did. So I was thinking maybe if every day I'll take a different subject and I'll show you what I'm doing with each of my kids. So yeah, if you think that sounds fun, here we go. Let's do a little homeschool tour. So for our morning routine, I set my alarm for 5 so that I'm up before the kids, and I make myself a cup of tea, and I usually take about an hour or so to sit and pray. I have some meditations, like some Bible meditations that I go through, and I journal my prayers, and I just spend some time praying before the kids get up. Usually they give me about an hour, sometimes they don't give me any time at all. And then when the kids get up, I make them breakfast, get them all ready for the day. And once they're ready, we're pretty flexible. We usually start somewhere between 7:30, 8:30, maybe even 9, depending on how our day is going. So then we go to our school area and we start our school day. So I'm going to show you our school area. So I've done this a bunch of different ways. We've tried school at the dining room table. We've tried school like in our living room on the couches. And this year we transitioned to more of like a one-room schoolhouse type thing. I'm a teacher by education, and I taught in high school for a few years, so I really thrive in that teacher kind of role. I think I do better, you know, with patience and with teaching my kids when I put myself in that teacher role. So we're going to try this out, this little one-room schoolhouse thing. So let me show it to you. So we have, I bought these at Aldi, these tables, the little folding tables for the kids. And then we have a bench. So we have a kid who sits here, a kid who sits here. And then we have this table for the two littles. So I have 4 kids. Hey, honey. So I got a station for my 2 big kids and then a station for their littles with their little toddler chairs. And I'm not very strict about this. Like, if they need to move and run and play and take breaks or go somewhere quiet, or that's fine. But we kind of, we're centered here because then I can bounce back and forth between all the different kids. So let me talk to you about how I keep the baby busy. Here's like a whole shelf full of toys that he can pretty much just grab and take to his little seat here next to his sister so that he feels like he's involved in the school day, and then he has something to play with. Some of it's educational, some of it's just gotta keep you busy. And then, oh, another thing, my kids love this. We have this pole in our basement here, and next to it we have this couch, and the kids climb on it and they swing on the pole and they jump up and down and whatever, and sometimes they just need to be active and it helps them concentrate. And so over here is my kind of, I guess you could say, teacher desk. Here's my tea. I usually make a second tea when we start our school day. So here's my teacher desk. This is kind of like my command center. So this is my, I have some learning manipulatives that don't come out unless I say they come out. Those are in here, extra pencils, extra glue sticks, all that kind of stuff. My timers, we do timers sometimes for breaks, and then there are certain subjects, like subjects that we do memorization, that we use a timer for. Our dry erase markers, pens and pencils. The trash has to be way up there because otherwise the baby empties it. And then up here we have our prize drawer. If the kids have a real good day, I let them get prizes. So here's my my teacher bin right here, all my teacher books, and I'll be telling you guys a little bit more about our subjects. And then my daughter's work, they each have a bin here, and we keep their work here along with their buckets with their school supplies. We got the diffuser we like to run sometimes, and then we have our crucifix. This is actually from Stella Marigold Art. I'll tell you a little bit more about this project on a different day. And then we have the picture from, we did our back to homeschool pilgrimage to Our Lady of Częstochowa Shrine. Okay, and then my son actually keeps his big bin of work on his desk, because he's a little bit more independent than the other, so he can kind of know what he has to do and go from subject to subject, whereas the other kids, I kind of have to give them more guidance. All right, each of my kids has a checklist for the school day, so they know what they've done and what they have to go through. Ooh, you see our posters back there? Those are our school posters, too. So here's an example. Hang on, sweetie. Here's an example of the checklist that we have, and we put them in these page protectors so they can dry erase, they can check it off every day, the things they have to do every day. Oh, he earns science time. He does a science video game that I'll tell you about, but he earns science time by completing his other subjects. And each of my kids has one of these so that they can keep track of their work. And also, this clear thing right here is like a little photo stand or whatever. Each day, my big kids, they'll put into that clear thing, they'll put the work that they're most proud of. Hang on, sweetheart. That day, so that when Daddy gets home from work, he can look at their schoolwork and he can check out what they're doing and he can, you know, praise their work. All right, so that's what we have going on here. Over here we have a bin of, these are school things for, this is like our reading curriculum and our preschool curriculum. All right, and then over here, oh, here's my, this is our board for morning prayer and for the pledges, and we put that in the morning, and then we'll take it off. We have a chalkboard here on my easel. My husband bought me this easel years ago, and I just love it. So we have a chalkboard there to do some of our classroom work. Sometimes I'll write notes up there, and then my big kids, they each have, ooh, can you get the tablet? Let's show the little tablet. Sometimes I'll write notes up there. Sometimes I'll have the kids come work up here, and then we have a big bucket of chalk. Yep, so each of my kids has one of these little tablets. It's not a screen. I don't really know how to describe it, but they do some of their scrap work on there, and they take some notes in there, and it kind of helps motivate them. Oh, we also, for the, hang on, sweetheart. We're going to do that in a different day. We have these drawing boards that we can switch onto the easel, and I have like a big roll of paper so that the kids can do their projects and some drawing on the easel if that's what we want to do. So basically, that is our school station. Oh, one more thing that I wanted to tell you guys about. I'm usually bouncing back and forth between all the kids, and you know, I kind of stay in this area, or I'll go with them if I need to, but I find myself kneeling on the floor a lot to be close to them and help them. So I put this little kneeling pad on the floor here in front of their desk so that when I go to get close to them, I can kneel on the kneeling pad and my knees are not killing me. So yeah, that's a little tour of our homeschool area, and check back tomorrow. And tomorrow I'll begin, we always begin our day with religion first, our faith studies first. So tomorrow I'll begin by showing you our religion curriculum, and then we'll just take it day by day, subject by subject. All right, thanks for tuning in. Bye-bye.